They're little, they're fast, sometimes they can be downright pesky. Now, I'm not talking about your kids, I'm talking about insects. We know we should study them as part of our nature study and our science curriculum, but why? What is it about insects that can get us excited and want to study more about them? Welcome to the Simply Charlotte Mason podcast. I'm Sonya Schaefer. Today we want to talk about why study insects. And joining me is my friend, Karen Smith. Karen, if we talk about insects, I know you're the expert to go to find out why on earth should we? You know, I often refer to things that we study in nature as nature friends. And I remember recently one mom called me on that. And she was like, a mosquito is not a nature friend.
Well, yes, it is.
That's why we're here today. Why would you call it a friend? What is it about insects that we need to keep in mind?
Well, just briefly, in the case of a mosquito, you may not like them, but they are very necessary for your livelihood. Yes, we don't like it when they bite us, but they are an essential part of the food chain in the ecosystem. So apart from that, the biggest reason that we should study insects is because they're part of God's creation.
That's true. There was a reason that he made them.
Many reasons, but yeah. Yes. But anything that's a part of God's creation, we should study at some point in our lives. We should get to know the things that God created. He created the things for our benefit.
And we learn more about him by looking at what he designed and made. I mean, just like you can learn about a person by looking at what kind of art they produce or what kind of food they cook or, you know, what kind of handicraft they do. It tells you about that person.
Yes, about what, that person, what they like, what they don't like, how they think.
I mean, that
sort of a thing, yes. So, yes, they're part of creation, so we should study them just from that. But if you need more reasons, I have more.
Oh, give us more. Okay. Give us more. That's a good one to start with, but give us more.
Insects are very interesting. I know most people go, ooh, a bug. Why would we want it? Let's kill it.
They crawl around.
Let's get rid of it.
Yeah, they bite you, you're done.
But there is such a wide variety of insects. There's everything from ants to beetles to butterflies to bees and to various hopping insects. And that only scratches the surface of what is out there. There is such a great variety. So get to know some of those varieties or as many as you can.
You're not going to run out of things to study.
You are not going to run out of things to study. There are more insects than any other creature on Earth.
Including people.
And I don't just mean like there are a million mosquitoes living in your backyard type thing. There are more species of insects than any other creature on Earth. Scientists have named and discovered about 1 million insects.
Wow. 1 million types of insects.
1 million species of insects.
Wow.
A conservative estimate of 4 million are left undiscovered. So you have the opportunity by studying insects to maybe discover one that has not been discovered before. So isn't that a good reason?
That's a good reason. That's a good reason.
They are also easy to find.
Oh, yes.
They're easy to study. They live virtually everywhere on the Earth, from the poles to the tropics and everywhere in between. The only place that they have not found any insects yet living would be the oceans.
Oh, interesting.
So anywhere you live, there are insects to study. So, no excuses.
Very convenient to get at them.
They're
around.
Yes.
Great.
Another reason to study insects is that we cannot live without them.
Now, that's interesting. Tell me more about that.
Now, I briefly mentioned that
the mosquitoes
are part of the food chain and part of the whole ecosystem. If you eliminated mosquitoes, we'd be in trouble. Insects pollinate our plants. They are what help us to have fruits and vegetables for us to eat. They also break down waste.
Oh, really?
Yes. So we do not live in a garbage dump because of insects. Many, many insects take care of things that are dead and other wastes that are produced by other animals.
That's true, yeah.
So, good reasons.
Mm-hmm.
We can't live without them.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good thing to study them.
That's true. Nice. What else?
There are different ways that they benefit humans. We talked about pollinating.
Mm-hmm.
So they do that and breaking down waste and dead things. Some insects actually aerate our soil for us. Ants make tunnels.
Yes, they do.
So they aerate the soil. They are a food source. In some parts of the world, they do eat insects.
Yes.
Now, as Americans, we're a bit put off by that. Some might think it's a novelty to have a lollipop with some insect in it. They might, you know, think that that's a great thing, kind of fun. But in other parts of the world, they are a food source for them. That's what they live on.
I've been reading about the rise of eating crickets.
Yes.
That those are starting. And, I mean, it's nothing new. You think back, John the Baptist ate locusts and wild honey. So
yes.
It's nothing new.
Yes. I know there are places. I have a friend who has been in a country in Africa, and they eat caterpillars.
Hmm.
So, you know, there are
places where they're a food source.
Yes.
Yeah.
Some insects are used to control other insects that are pests to our plants. So
you do this in your garden, don't you?
Well, I plant things or I let things grow so that it will draw the beneficial insects that will help take care of the ones that are pests in my garden. Yes, they don't take care of all of them, but they do help. And so, yes, you want those insects to come and help with that. Farmers want them to help control pests. There's just, I mean, it's a useful thing for us. That's how we benefit from them. They're also a resource for different products that we use. Silk we get from insects.
That's true, silkworms.
Floor polish comes from insects.
It does.
Ink can come from insects. Varnish can come from insects. Beeswax, most people are familiar with beeswax.
True.
We use that.
Yeah, we use it a lot.
For different things.
Yeah.
So those are things that we get from insects. Insects provide us with those. Is this interesting?
It is.
Is this why we should study them?
Yeah, there's a lot of reasons here I hadn't thought about before.
Insects can be used to help solve crimes. Different insects, so if you have a murder, trying not to be, I don't want to gross anybody out with
right,
things, but
right,
if there's
yeah.
a murder, different insects will come at different times. And so they can predict how long a body has been decomposing based upon what insects are found there.
So it's a part of forensics.
Yes.
Wow.
So it can help solve crimes in that way. We have actually made products based upon what we see insects doing in nature. So examples would be antifreeze. Antifreeze was invented because insects use a type of antifreeze, some do, to keep themselves from freezing in the wintertime.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
Other things, Velcro.
Okay, I'm not connecting Velcro to insects.
So their legs have different, you know, so it was the person who invented Velcro studied insects and noticed how things worked with that.
So it's
and so
legs.
Burrs also is something that they will say.
Oh,
the burrs with Velcro.
How they stick to things.
But
also
insects'
legs.
Yes.
Wow.
And the way that worked. And chainsaws, of all things. How insects can chew through things and how their jaws work was instrumental in inventing chainsaws. One other thing, genetic studies. Scientists often will use fruit flies.
Oh, yes.
To study genetics in humans. And I recently read about a study where they are studying the fruit flies to see what characteristics a father passes on to his children. So they're studying the fruit flies to learn how humans pass different characteristics on to their children through the father. So those are reasons to study insects. It's a fascinating world. They are fascinating creatures. You don't have to get up close and personal. You can study them from a distance if you want, especially the scarier ones.
Well, I know we did an episode previously on if your child is afraid of a certain mm-hmm. insect, or if you are of a certain nature friend, how to help them with that, not force it, but yes. how to help them. So we'll put a link to that one. Yes, because sometimes insects especially, as I mentioned, they're fast and they're little, and they can
bite
come
or
at
sting.
You. Yeah.
And that can be scary, but they're still fascinating creatures to study.
And it seems like it all comes back around to your first reason. I mean, all these things you talked about are showing God's design
yes.
and handiwork in how he created insects to operate in this world.
Yes.
It
so
all ties back to it's his creation.
Yes. I have a quote I'd like to read. This I actually found at the beginning of a chapter on a book on insects. And this is from James Rennie, who wrote Insect Architecture, published in 1857.
Hmm.
And he stated, "It can never be too strongly impressed upon a mind anxious for the acquisition of knowledge that the commonest things by which we are surrounded are deserving of minute and careful attention."
The commonest things.
The commonest things are insects. They are all around us, found everywhere, except
the
oceans.
Yeah.
They're easy to study. And I love how he says, "It cannot be too strongly impressed upon the mind anxious for the acquisition of knowledge."
Mm. Yes. And too often, if our minds as parents are not anxious to learn more about insects, it's going to be hard to get our kids interested
yes.
in it as well.
Yes. If we don't care, our children are not going to care. Or most likely are not going
most
to care.
Likely, yeah.
Sometimes you have a child who cares about things that you don't.
Right.
And
yes.
and that's good because they're individuals. But many times what we're interested in, our children will take an interest in too, because they see us learning more about those things.
Fascinating ideas. And I'm sure you have included a lot of great living books about insects in your living book list, science living book mm-hmm. list, that's on our website. We'll leave a link to that. And many of those are written into the science courses
yes.
that you have written as well.
Yes.
So, yeah, if people are looking for some books to supplement that study and learn about some of these aspects that you mentioned that you can't necessarily know just by observing the insects, those would be great resources. We'll leave links to those as well.
Yes.
Thanks so much. If you enjoyed this podcast, be sure to subscribe through iTunes, Google Play, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, or your favorite podcast app so you don't miss an episode. We'll leave links in the show notes to all those great resources to help you give your children that love for insects, an important and vital part of God's creation. Thanks for joining me. I'll see you next time.